It's Mommy Tang.
What's up, Tang Gangs?
Don't you feel a little bit more personal with me now that you've seen what's going on over here and over there and all around my house? I'm kind of glad that I showed my house to you guys because I feel like I'm more, you know, like personal. Also, yeah, last night, I know you guys like, you know, comment a lot about my hair. As you can see, I still have the blondes. Let me just tell you, it was okay with my husband, you know? So last night, right? Funny story. Last night, I was like, right, he came home late. So I was like, okay, how am I gonna do this, you know? So I actually put my hair up in a ponytail like this, like in a messy bun. And I put this little thing on my hair, you know, he can't really tell. So I greet him and I was like, hello. And he was like, hello. And then, you know, and then we went to bed. Now I don't like anything on my hair when I go to bed. So I took everything out. I went to bed. I woke up this morning. I totally forgot about my hair. So I come downstairs to make him breakfast. So we're talking. I'm like, oh, honey, do you see this? And we're just talking about things. And it clicked. I was like, oh my God, my hair. So I was like, how am I going to pull this off? You know, so I said, oh, yeah, I have my hair. Do you like my hair? It's a little light. And after he looked at it, it's like he had like a blank face. And he's like, yeah, I already saw it. I'm like, what? And he's like, your Snapchat. And I was like, oh, oh, you like it? And he was like, yeah, nice, you know. And I was like, I gotta make sure that, you know, like he knows what he said, because sometimes you tell your men something and like, you know, you said it and he knows you said it too maybe, but he tells you like days later, like, I don't remember that. I'm like, I told you we have a wedding this Saturday. And he's like, I don't remember you telling me that. And you're like, what? Just so he won't do that to me about my hair. I was like, so you like it? You don't think it's light? Like, don't, making sure that he understands. And he was like, no, I guess it's nice, except it's too long. That's what he said. He doesn't like girls with long hair. He thinks my hair is way too long. And I'm like, listen, I am 40 and I can't have this long hair when I'm 50. It will look kind of funny, I think, you know, like, especially for Asian older women, they all have short hair. Do you notice that? Because they think short hair looks better, or they think that it's more appropriate. I don't know. Anyway, so I have to see my mother-in-law today and my father-in-law tonight, and I don't want them to freak out because it was like it wasn't a gradual change. It was all of a sudden like black to blonde, you know. Like if you see me in person, it's a lot lighter. So this is the hair that I pull off because, you know, from the front you can't really see. You can only see my face, as you could tell. When you turn around though, you can see my blondes. Look. See, they're kind of hidden, but and then I'll slowly put it down, so slowly get into their nerves, I guess. Today, this recipe was requested long time ago and many, many times, because I ate this in one of my very first mukbang, and they're like, we want recipe. And I put this on, I think, Instagram as well, and they wanted recipe. I have bean sprouts for you. Soybean sprouts. Yeah, you could find this. I'm gonna be again say 98% of the time you could find this at Korean supermarkets. If you don't have a supermarket, because I think Koreans are the only one that eats soybean sprouts. I don't know any other culture that eats soybean sprouts. I have no idea, but they're so good. I really didn't like them growing up. We didn't really eat that much. My husband's family, they ate a lot of this. So when I got married to him, he's like, they had this every single dinner time. So you could actually grow these at home. You could YouTube it. Maybe I'll grow it one day and share it with you, but I don't have time for that right now. Sorry. You could like look at just how to grow soybeans. You know, I think the lady, Mangchi lady, you know, she's Korean. She does Korean recipes. She's not vegan, but she's like really famous for posting all these Korean recipes. I think she has a recipe on how to grow these. So check that out. But anyways, so they come in a package like this. Okay. Or they come in a bigger package, but this is pretty much everywhere you go, especially if you live in the United States, this is the package you'll see. The only thing is that they might be really fresh, but if you buy them, put in the refrigerator, they go pretty like bleh in 2 days, something like that. So what I usually do is I bring it home, I put it in a nice plastic bag with a paper towel underneath it, to catch the moisture and stuff like that. And then so if you want to keep them longer, but you should really use it that day or the day after for like, you know, whatever. You can make soups with these. When you order bibimbap, this is in there. You could make a side dish. You could do, oh, rice dishes. You could make sushi with these. You could, oh, there's so many recipes using these soybean sprouts. So today I'm gonna teach you how to make one very famous one in Korea because a lot of the restaurants use it. They're cheap. I think this bag was 99 cents or something like that. So you can make this at home, okay? So please look for it and I hope you make it, you know? Okay. So when you get them, you want to rinse them out in cold water. It's very important that you rinse it out. I'll show you why. I actually saved the water while I was rinsing, okay? This was my second rinsing out. You'll see all this like, you know, they're not that clean. You see how dirty it is? Like, it's like cloudy and, you know, like whatever. So you wanna keep on washing and washing maybe two or three times so you get clean sprouts. And if you see like blackheads, you wanna take it out. You wanna, you know, take out whatever that doesn't look clean, like this, okay? And then just trash that part and use the clean part. Are we ready for the recipe? Let's go. So get a pot, any pot of your choice, and put the sprouts in there first. Oops. I was wrong. Never mind. Let's start all over again. Pretend that never happened. First, get water. Okay, you're gonna put very, very little bit, like half a cup, not even. I don't know, like very, it depends how many soy sprout you have, but very little bit. It's almost like so it won't burn. You know, there's no need for all this water. You're just gonna steam it, okay? You're gonna put some sea salt in there. For some reason, a lot of Koreans don't do this part, but this is the way to make yummy, yummy sprouts, to steam it with salt water, you know? Some people just steam it without the salt. I really recommend that you use salt water. And then you put the sprouts in. Did I like totally cover my face there? Sorry. Sorry about that, sorry. See, sometimes you'll see like blackheads like this. See how black this one is? Do you see how black it is? I don't know, let's see. Oh. So you wanna take stuff out like that, and you're going to steam them, okay? Now, mung bean sprouts, you could eat them raw. Soybean sprouts, you shouldn't eat them raw because they have this flavor. Not the actual stem, but the yellow part of it, the head part, it has very fishy, not fishy, I don't know, like bean, you know how like sprouts have that like really raw flavor, like really raw, I can't explain it, but you know what I mean, right? This sprout has it a lot, so you want to really, you don't want to overcook it, but you want, you're basically cooking the head, not the stem. Stem cooks really easy, just you want to cook it till you don't taste the rawness anymore, okay? I'm sorry. You know how I can explain things, you guys. Okay, I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry. Let's work on the garnish while we do this. Save time. So of course, we need some carrots. And the last time I did a recipe, I need to put some chives in there. I just can't find any chives right now at home. So I'm just gonna use the basic recipe, okay? I mean, if you add chives, it will be a lot better, I guess. So there are two options. You could do your knife skill and do that, and then make tiny, you know what I mean, slices like this of carrots. You could do that. If your knife skill is not that good, then use one of these like tools. They are so cheap now, they sell it everywhere. And you just do this. Obviously not like that. You know, and I think it went into my bra. Oh, God. Classy, real classy. Okay, so you want to make little, you know, thinner, smaller is always better, okay? Because you don't want the carrot to overpower the flavor, the sprouts, okay? So you just wanna make a little bit, just, this is for the garnish, okay? And the rest of it, don't ask me what you're gonna do with it. Eat it, I don't know. Oh, it's asking me,
good?
Same question. Scallions, you want to cut them small? If you don't mind big scallions, then do big, you know? But always scallions taste better when they're sliced small, you know, small slices. This does bring out the flavor, but it's for the garnish purposes as well. This is good enough, I think. Okay, put them aside. Mommy Tang, how do you know they're done? I never had this before, so how do you know? Take one. Eat it, okay? If it's too bitter, then you gotta cook it a little bit more. If it's like too soggy, then that means that you overcook it. So next time you cook it, you just cook a little less. But I think like about 3 minutes or so in on high heat is good, yeah. I think they're done. We're cooking sprouts here, okay? We're not cooking no lamb chop or something, you know? So you want to transfer them over. Woo! That was hot. I almost burned myself there. Woo! It's still hot. I almost burned myself there. Okay. Transfer them over to a bowl, a mixing bowl, I guess. I looked all serious and everything, right? Now you have to cool it a little bit only because you need to marinate this with your hands. A lot of Korean dish, you have to use your hands, okay? You can't be using tools to make things tasty. So for your convenience, Koreans actually make this disposable plastic gloves. I got this for 79 cents US. There's 50 pieces in there. You just take one out like so. They're very thin. And you could put it in and use it to, you know, so you don't get your hands dirty. Actually, I don't think this is very environment friendly. So it's your call, you know. I don't use it often, but when I do have guests coming to my house and I gotta make stuff like this, I use it, you know, so they don't feel gross about it. Because sometimes you don't want people touching your hand and all, you know what I mean? Okay, so you want to air them out a little bit because they're hot, okay? So you could use chopstick or whatever you need to air them out, like some soy sauce. Very little bit, guys. Like, tiny bit. Just for the flavor, okay? Remember we salted already when we cooked it? So it's just for the flavor. Fluff it out, okay? Every time you put an ingredient on, you want to fluff it out, okay? Next, you want to put some sugar. Any type of sugar you have, it's fine. Remember I told you, I forgot to go food shopping. I don't have sugar in the house. It's kind of weird, but I don't right now. So I'm gonna use a coconut nectar. It's like coconut sugar in a syrup form. Yeah. Mix it well, okay? Every ingredient, mix it well. Next, garlic powder. Clean that cap later. Mix it really well. And then just give it a little taste. You'll be like, whoa. I gotta take my gloves off because I really don't want to touch this with my gloves on. Some black pepper. All that, all this work just for that. Black pepper makes huge difference in this recipe, I think, in my opinion. Oh my God. Look, I want you to try this bean sprouts every time you add a little bit of the spices and you'll be like, oh my gosh. And that's when you kind of learn about spices because every time, that's how I learn it, you know, because every time you add something, you eat it, and you're like, wow, this ingredient brings this kind of flavor out. You learn, you know, so you could use it in other recipes. Now, I have some Korean chili flakes. Guess who gave them to me? Mother-in-law. She sent me some gochugaru. Yeah. You could, if you have hard time finding gochugaru, get it from her website. You know what I mean? Now, this is very optional. If you don't like it spicy, then at this point, you just want to skip this and move on to the next part. But a lot of people like this spicy. You know, this tastes good spicy, so that's what I'm going to do. But some people, like when I make it for my babies, I skip this part. Okay? But you're going to love this one. If you love kimchi, you're going to love this one. Okay? So remember, I told you, mix, mix, mix. 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 Finally. Some sesame oil. You know, you could skip this part too if you don't like any oil, but it does make everything up to a next level. It's like French fries, you know? You could bake them, it tastes good, but when you fry them, they taste really good, you know? It's one of those. It smells so wonderful. Every time you put sesame oil into things, it just smells so good. I don't know what it is, but it just does. Yes. You could, of course, add more salt, more spices, whatever you want, you know? Okay. Are we ready to eat? First nut! Sesame seed! The one that Payne destroyed, do you remember? Protein, protein! It's like working out, you know? Sesame seeds all over my table. Oh, I think I'm done. Okay, so the secret to making Korean food look really good on the table, okay, is to pretty much use white plate. I don't know, they look the best, okay? And what you want to do is you want to create like almost like a pyramid mountain, okay? Like so. See that? Okay? Like so. Oh my gosh! I am losing my mind. I forgot the carrots and green onions. I'm forgetting a lot of stuff today. I was like, something's missing. In goes in the carrots, in goes in the green onions. This just makes you, you know. Oh, Mommy Tang, why are you making so much mistakes? Because I am real. Real people make mistakes, okay? So you want to mix that up just for the color and all that stuff. It's gonna look better. Okay, now you place it. Ooh, it wasn't a big mistake. It was just a little mistake. You know?
I like that, Mommy.
I know you love this one. You love this one, right? Pepita. Okay, so you want to create a mountain. You can't really see it now, but I'll show you what I mean. See this? See how I created the mountain? I have a bowl of rice. I'll be eating it with also kimchi, except I ran out of mother-in-law's kimchi. I ate it all. I told you, remember, I was running low in a lot of stuff. Mother-in-law kimchi is one of them. So I went to H Mart and got myself a vegan baek kimchi. White kimchi. 80% of the time, white kimchis are vegan because they don't need to put all this fish sauce and, you know, shrimp based sauce, stuff like that. But these days, some companies, they mess with your kimchi, you know, they put MSG and they put, you know, like beef broth and stuff. I've seen it, okay? So be careful, but this brand definitely is vegan. Let me just double check, okay? Because it's French and English and everything, you know what I mean? But this product, this company right here, 종갓집, right here, is very popular brand. So they won't mess with you. You just have to make sure that you're getting it from a good company. Pepita.
Mm-hmm.
Pepita.
Mm-hmm.
Pepita.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm gonna be honest with you. I've never had this kimchi, so I don't know what it's gonna taste like. I don't know. Mmm, it smells wonderful.
Ooh. Nice, Kelly.
Mmm. Mmm. Smells like good kimchi, right? Okay, I'm gonna put this away because I'm gonna work on this for now.
It smells
like a good kimchi, right?
No, I did do it.
Whoa!
I
oh, excuse me. Excuse me.
I think
it's one cabbage in one package. Let me see. Is there more in there?
Next, can I do it?
No. But you could drink this, okay? You could actually drink this and there's a recipe for this, so save it. Don't trash it, okay? It's one of those, like, you know this pickle juice you just kind of trash? It's not one of those. Hold on, hold on. Look at that. Ooh, white kimchi, guys.
Not dry. Not dry.
Let me see.
Not dry.
It's good, right, Peppy?
Mm-hmm.
It's really good, guys. It's really good. Oh.
Mom.
Oh.
Love it.
I'm definitely gonna enjoy my meal today.
It's too loud.
Hmm?
It's too loud.
Mmm. I just cooked my rice. It's so good. Mmm.
Now can you tell me?
Oh my god.
Now can I eat it?
Mm-hmm.
Is this?
Oh my god.
This is good. I never tried it before.
Oh my gosh, guys. I'm telling you. Mmm. Mmm. Oh my god.
No.
Mmm. Mmm. So healthy. So good. Pepita. Mmm. Of course, you could cut the white kimchi, you know, before you put it on the table. But I don't know, kimchi sometimes tastes so good like this, you know? The white kimchi is not spicy, so you could take like a big amount of kimchi in your mouth and it's okay. Come over here, Pepita. Are you hurt or embarrassed? Careful, okay? You want another kimchi and rice?
No, I want kimchi. You
want kimchi?
I want kimchi.
Kimchi's good, right? I tried mother-in-law's kimchi, the white kimchi, it was really good too.
I want to stop.
No, you need to eat it with it or I'm not going to give it to you. The white kimchi from mother-in-law was really good too. It was very good quality. I think that's why I like mother-in-law's kimchi, because I feel like it, even though it's vegan, it's very close to the Korean original kimchi, you know? The original.
Hey guys, so my mom had something stuck right here, like a piece of food. for like the last 3 or 5 minutes. She realized it when she was editing, so she says she's really sorry. Bye. Oh, and plus, my Musical.ly account. You might have a mom, she might be the bomb, but ain't nobody got a mom like mine. Her love's till the end, she's my best friend. Ain't nobody got a mom like mine. You might have a mom. So that's what it is, and bye guys, bye Tanging!
Oh my god, I forgot to get water. I need to get water. What did you do?
Can I have water?
Let me see, what are you drinking? Water! It's just, I'm using the recycle of the bottle. Ice water, ice water.
Ice water.
So nosy, hey. Puppy dog, try this one. You love this one, remember? But you gotta eat rice a little bit, because always eat rice with your veggies, you know? Yeah. How was it? How was that?
Good.
Don't be stingy with the spices, okay? Like, if you want it sweeter, then put more sugar. If you want it spicier, then put more spice. Like, don't be stingy with anything. So yesterday I put, you know, my house tour, you know? Some of you say, oh, your house is so beautiful. Your house is so nice. Thank you. Thank you. And I really mean that. Thank you, you know? I feel very lucky to live in this kind of house, this kind of environment, you know? I tell my kids all the time, feel lucky, you know? Not everybody in the world gets to have what you have. That's what I tell them. My next question was though, ooh, what does Daddy Tang do? What does he do for a living? For you to, you know, live in a house like that. People say, is he a doctor? Is he a lawyer or dentist or something?
Mama.
Hmm.
I want some more.
Hmm?
I want some more.
Hmm. This one or this one?
This
one?
Mm-hmm.
We love kimchi. I'm gonna give you a big piece like this. You think you can handle it?
Mm-mm.
Too big?
Mm-mm.
Mm. Mm. What does he do? He works very hard. That's what he does, okay? Let me just tell you something. What I tell my kids all the time. I tell my kids, you could become whatever you want. Anything you want to become, you could try for it. But know what you're doing. Practice what you're doing and dream about it. Okay, what do you mean, mommy? Think, dream about it.
Mom, can I have some more?
people fail on things they do because they don't dream. They just do it without dreaming about it.
I want that.
You know? So they're like, what do you mean you don't dream about it?
I want that.
I did put that in there. Look.
More little bit.
What is more little bit? You always say that. What does that mean? More little bit. I'll be right back. Classy, right? Only some selected people, like selective, I said, I think the selected, is that the word? Selective? Could do stuff without dreaming and make it out in life. Most people, you really have to plan it out. See the future, plan it out, and take steps. You know, I tell them that all the time. Don't say you're gonna become a doctor, but don't realize what it takes to become a doctor. If you want to become a doctor, that means you have to love studying. You have to study. It's like doctors study till they die, pretty much. So if you don't like studying, you can't become a doctor. You know? You want to become a ballerina? You have to accept the fact that your feet gonna look weird. I've seen real ballerinas' toes. They don't look normal. You have to know that. You wanna become vegan? You have to know. No more eating hot dogs and pizzas and whatever you just like to eat. You know? That's the first step. And then plan it out. I'm gonna go to this school. I'm gonna go to this university. I'm gonna do this, do that. Plan it out. And then just live it. And by the time you get there, you look back and you're like, I'm here with what I want. Me and my husband, when we first got married, we lived in an apartment, a one-bedroom apartment. We did. Everybody made fun of him, fun of us, because we didn't really buy Jaden that much toys either. We make him go to his neighbor's house and play with their toys, you know, because you know those cars that you drive outside where you put the batteries in, they drive around the neighborhood. They were like $300-$400 at the time. We won't buy that for him because we were saving money to get a house like this, to do whatever my husband wanted to do with his life, you know? We did. You'll be surprised. People with big homes, they don't eat out as much. They don't spend their money on like stupid things, clothes and stuff like that. They're very frugal in a way. That's why they have big houses, because they save money so they could buy whatever they want. You know, if you're always spending, you're never gonna get what you want. You know, money wise. I tell my kids, like I said all the time, be whatever you wanna be. I'll push you, I'll support you, but know what you need to do behind what you want to do, you know? There's always suffering and hardship, and there's fail, you fall, you'll get hurt. If you could embrace all that, then say you want to become whatever, you know? Does it make sense? So you ask me what my husband does? He works hard. He had dream, you know? He wanted to build a home for us where we live very comfortably, like this, where financially we don't have to worry about a lot of things. That's what he dreamed about, and he just worked really hard for it, and that's why we have this home. So even with YouTube, guys, seriously, I worked really, really a lot for this moment here. You think this mukbang is easy, right? Sometimes it is, I agree, it is easy, but sometimes it's hard. I had to lose a lot of weight. Didn't I tell you? I used to be a little bit chubbier. I lost about good 55 plus. You know, I told myself, how am I gonna promote healthy food when I'm big? I gotta promote healthy food when I'm on a, you know, when I look presentable to people that want to lose weight, that want to get healthy. I'm not saying I have a perfect body. That's not what I'm saying, okay? This recipe here, I must have made it more than probably 50, 60 times in my lifetime in order for me to share with you with confidence. You know, 10 years, 15 years, I made this so many times, I can't even count how many times I made this. Sometimes this is what I say. There's a swan on a lake, okay? Beautiful swan floating above the water. You know, it looks so graceful. You know what's going under the water? Like crazy. On the top, they're like, on the bottom, they're like, you know? You gotta be like that a little bit. When you present yourself out in the world, you gotta look, I know what I'm doing, I'm graceful, you know? But at the bottom, you gotta work hard. Does that make sense? I know there are a lot of the college kids watching me, because I get a lot of snaps saying, Mommy Tam, I'm watching you while I'm studying. I'm like, what? Okay, that's what you need to do. Isn't that? What?
I want to pinch it.
I have this amazing, amazing recipe for you. Using this white kimchi next week. Come back next week, okay? On top of that, in the middle of the week, I have another amazing surprise for you. Waiting for you guys. You guys are gonna love it. There's some episode, some recipes, whatever, that I think in my head, and I'm like, oh my God, they will love it. They will love it. And usually I post it and you guys love it. You guys are like, oh, Mommy Tam, we love you, you know? Next week, you guys are gonna love what I have for you. I promise. So remember to stay graceful above the water, under the water. Make sure you, like a crazy person, okay? Whatever you do, focus, have big dreams, follow, plan it out, live it, don't give up. I feel like I'm like a dream speaker or something. God, the time's ticking. I gotta eat this fast.
Mommy, kimchi. Want kimchi. Booba. Kimchi. Kimchi. Booba. Booba.
I'm not fast forwarding you guys. I'm just eating, okay? Some people tell me, oh my God, you eat so fast. I'm like, you haven't seen me eat fast. When I'm in a hurry, I eat fast. And this is the moment. I put potato today. So good. How can kimchi be just so good? I don't understand. How can plant food be this good? When the rice is done, the mukbang is done. I'll see you later, Tang Gangs. Remember.